You know, I'm often asked why I always play the same Fender Stratocaster in pretty much all my videos. And, you know, if I use very many other electric guitars, stuff like that. One time I even had an email sent in to me off my website, and the guy asked if I'm some kind of Brian May fan, because I'm always hooked on using, you know, the same guitar all the time, just like Brian May. I don't know if that had anything to do with anything, but it was kind of funny. And so what we're going to do is, on this week's Guitar Blog Insider, I'm going to discuss some tonal reasons and some of the ways I like the sound that comes here out of the Fender Stratocaster, and really why I, in particular, prefer the Fender Strat for almost everything I do. Just so basically, this is a video on why I love playing the Fender Stratocaster. Well, the first reason that I initially wanted a Strat as a kid, and why I felt that the Stratocaster's design and its style was the right one for me, actually had to do with just a simple reason of my early guitar heroes. They all played Strats. You know, so, you know, one of the first guys ever that blew my mind on guitar was Stevie Ray Vaughan. And then, of course, it was Jimi Hendrix and Ritchie Blackmore from the Rainbow days, because I was a huge Ronnie James Dio fan, and that sound that those guys generated, you know, was just amazing. Also, I liked Pink Floyd quite a bit, so David Gilmour was up there. And then, you know, later I got into Eric Clapton, and then later yet I discovered Eric Johnson and Yngwie Malmsteen and some of the shredders that were, you know, big inspiration early on. And as you're probably well aware, they all played Fender Stratocasters. Now, you know, in the early days, I wasn't sure why they all played Strats. I just thought it was because the guitar probably gave this amazing sound, and I wanted one, you know, at that point. The first time I ever got one, it was sort of a Strat copy. It was just sort of one of those, you know, made in some, you know, other country Stratocaster copy. It wasn't a Strat at all. It wasn't even made by Fender, but it was looked just like it. I think the guitar body was even made out of plywood. It weighed a ton, and, you know, but to me, it looked like a Strat, and it, you know, to me, it probably played like a Strat. And I wondered really what it was that people liked about them, because I felt that the three single coil pickup design actually had an awful tone, you know, with distortion and overdrive cranked. It was just loud and buzzy, and it picked up all the hum of and cycle hum, and it was just, I didn't even really like it. And actually, you know, because I was young, I was only 12 or 13 years old at the time, and I actually bought another guitar because I just couldn't get any kind of a sound I was happy with out of that Stratocaster clone guitar. And so I gave up on Strats for a while. I didn't really, you know, follow that direction until I actually picked up this one, because I guess when I was young, you know, I had no idea that you could swap out pickups and you could, you know, do some electronics changes and that would actually make a difference. But as I got older and I realized a little bit more about how to do that stuff, it was kind of clear to me that all I had to do was rip out some pickups, put some hot rod pickups in there, and I could start getting the kind of sounds that I really always wanted. When I got a little more serious about my playing, and I took the plunge and purchased my first, you know, Fender USA Stratocaster for a whopping $400, that was around 26 years ago, I guess, which is this one right here. I never even really let it leave the store without changing out the bridge pickup. I kind of learned my lesson, you know, from a kid, and realized that I immediately needed to replace that single coil bridge pickup so I had more flexibility with the guitar. I went with a Seymour Duncan hot rail, and it's always been in there. This is the same Seymour Duncan hot rail that I first put in when I bought the guitar. It's been there for literally over 25 years and still runs great. And, you know, it offered right away a really nice rhythm tone when combined with that stock middle pickup. So I had these two pickups going. You know, it was kind of a nice kind of a tone to it there for some rhythm guitar ideas, you know. I could really play, you know, some nice stuff. Could put a capo on, play all over the neck. Like maybe, you know, in the middle of the guitar, get a really nice sound with a lot of bar chording. It has a really, really nice tone to it, so it was really versatile. But then what was great was when I went into the bridge position pickup alone, just at Seymour Duncan hot rail, I could, you know, hit on the distortion and just get a really thick, you know, heavy, crunchy sound, you know. And it just sounds great. And it's way above and beyond what the single coil pickup could do. And it wasn't very many years after that where I went forward and replaced the neck pickup also. So I got rid of the neck pickup that was in there, the stock Fender Strat single coil, and I replaced it with a Seymour Duncan cool rail. Now what that did was that really, you know, sort of fed more to my sort of jazzy sounds, and I started getting, you know, that really nice sound of, you know, let's say if I wanted to do some, you know, jazz gigs or whatever, you know, I could get that nice jazzy sound out of this guitar now, you know, and it was just like 100% sound that I was after too. And I could also, in between, if I went to the fourth position pickup selection switch, I had another totally different sound for rhythm guitar, you know, as opposed to the in the bridge position with the middle position. Now with the neck position in middle, I had a really different flavor. So, you know, at that point, I had all these different sounds accessible on the guitar, and I felt that it was super versatile. I could almost kind of do anything I wanted to do with the instrument at that point. Back in the 1990s, from specifically around 1993 through to around early 2000s, maybe 2002, 2003, something within around that 10-year span, I was just working in all kinds of different playing situations. Like a lot of, you know, young guitar players starting their, you know, professional career, you're just playing everywhere, doing everything you can, doing all kinds of stuff. I mean, it's really different nowadays because you've got the internet and you've got all kinds of social media to kind of blow you up a little bit more. But I mean, like, you know, back then it was all word of mouth, and you need to hand out business cards, and you get, you know, one person recommending you to another. And, you know, it's really, that was really the element that you're at. And, you know, when I was doing that, I was doing, you know, a little bit of different stuff all the time. You know, I might do a jazz type of gig, you know, one night. Some jazzy chords like that or whatever, playing real book tunes or whatnot. Maybe I was doing something a few nights later that was, I had a group of people that I was in with where they did Latin, Caribbean stuff, reggae. So I might be doing sort of a reggae-ish type of thing another night, you know, something like, something like that, you know? And so you can tell what I did there was I switched over to the fourth position pickups position. Now I've got the middle, the Stratocaster single coil with the humbucker with that Seymour Duncan, and the blend of that, you know, gives a fantastic sound. Or if I was doing larger chords, I might go to the second pickup selection and do, you know, something like that. Like I'll play those same chord changes, but I'll do it with larger bar chords now. So I would have a little bit different impact of the sound of the guitar. Or, you know, of course, if, you know, a few nights later I was doing some kind of a rock gig, hard rock kind of thing, I may want to switch up completely and just sort of focus on the bridge pickup more. Maybe once in a while to get a little bit fatter, overdriven tone, I could flip over to the neck position. But, you know, with the bridge position there, I got a really nice, you know, rock tone. I could even flip it over and get a little bit fatter tone to that, you know. So, you know, you have some options there a little bit, but I mean, you know, depending on the color that you want, you can almost just keep flipping the switches around and gain whatever kind of control over the sound that you want with, you know, with my particular Stratocaster situation that I've got it rigged up to be. So I could always pull off the gig. I could always make any one of those playing styles work very nicely with having only one guitar. And, you know, the only thing I would be a little bit afraid of sometimes is, you know, you're playing in a club. Some of the places I've played at over the last, you know, decade have been a little bit rough around the edges, you know, and you get to the point sometimes where maybe you go to the washroom or something and you're wondering, oh, I left my Strat on stage. I hope I come back and the thing is there. Luckily, this guitar was never stolen. So, you know, it's like, you know, thank goodness. But, you know, the thing is that I always thought, well, if it got stolen, I'm going to have to buy another Strat and I'm going to have to set it up in the exact same way and basically just have the exact same guitar again, because I have it set up in a way that's just so versatile that, you know, over the years, as you're learning from me here, that it's just become the number one go-to guitar because it's something I can pretty much play any kind of sound and any kind of style on. Well, you know, in playing all these different styles and having to get the best tone for any one of these gigs, no matter what I was doing, if it was live on stage or maybe even if it was in the studio, because you got to remember, if you're recording something, you're probably layering tracks, so you're going to be recording multiple guitars on top of one another. And as you're doing that, you always want to change your sound just a little bit, because it's funny, in the studio, if you record the exact same tone of a guitar over top of itself, it actually takes away from the sound. It's almost like it diminishes the impact of the sound of that guitar overall. So multiple layered tracks, you know, you want to change your guitar sound up a lot. And what, you know, I find with this guitar combination of pickups and everything and sound, it just, you can do that very easily and always have a really nice sound, especially if you're layering the studio. And so, you know, the thing is as time went on, I started to feel more and more that it's not just what kind of gear that I was running through. In fact, it's probably gear, I would say, is, you know, almost like 50% or so of the sound. And it has also a lot to do with the way the guitar that you're playing is built. And with the Fender Stratocaster, I really liked how the guitar's five-way switch, you know, operated to create so many different guitar tonal responses out of the instrument. And also there's the amount of choice that you have with the layout and spacing of the Stratocaster's three pickup combination. You know, when you put some humbuckers in there like this, you know, you have quite a wide spread of sound, you know, from where the neck position pickup is to where the bridge position is. Well, you know, if I want to get, you know, that nice, deeper, thicker sounding tone from the neck position pickup, all I gotta do is just have all the tones cranked, have the volume cranked, put it over to the neck position, and I have a really nice, thick tone that I can jam out on. Great sound, you know, you can use it for a lot of your jazzy stuff and all that. But then too, off of that tone, I can switch up and get the middle pickup involved with that neck pickup, and I can get a really great rhythm guitar tone out of the instrument. You know? Even play a little bit of, you know, the odd lick there, especially if you want to grab into the string a little bit more and sort of snap at it. Cool sound out of that particular pickup. Now the same is true on the opposite end with the bridge in the middle and the bridge pickup on its own. Bridge and the middle pickup, really nice tone. You know, especially if you wanted to get that snappy sound again, you'll hear that a lot in some of the funk stuff and all that. Also, with you know, switching it just up over to only having the bridge pickup on by itself, you get this really interesting color when you mess around with some of the tone. You know, I usually take my first tone dial and I'll put it around halfway, and then I'll take the other one and put it just past halfway there, and you know, I'll get a really nice kind of, you know, a tone that's somewhat fat, but it's got some brightness to it. It's a, you know, really interesting sound. So you can, you know, fool around with some interesting colors, different kinds of ways of playing rhythm and lead with all these different frequency responses too, with the mixing of the different pickups that you can get, you know, across the Strat's five-way switch. And then also, you know, from messing around with the fact that you've got two tone controls that's, you know, spreads out, you know, through those three pickups. So you can really kind of shape your sound quite a bit, you know, whether you're using the bridge or the neck or how you're setting up, you know, your middle pickup. I don't use the middle pickup on its own very often. I just don't really care for the tone of it all that much. You know, it's not bad. Maybe sometimes if I'm layering something, doing a recording, it might be something, you know, interesting, but usually I don't use it. You know, with just this wide, you know, spectrum of sound that you can dial up, you can really do a lot of nice stuff for a lot of different playing styles. Well, I hope that you gain a little more insight about this Fender Strat here that I use through this description video. The flexibility that I have with this guitar, with these pickup combinations and everything, it really is what I feel allows me to have a lot of different playing options. And, you know, I did this just to describe what's going on with this guitar, why you see it in pretty much all the videos. I should mention that behind me, you're going to see there's that BC Rich with the Floyd Rose on it. I do use that for certain situations, but like I said, this guitar is my go-to guitar. And I just can get every sound imaginable out of it, and it's my, you know, number one instrument. And, you know, I wanted to mention too that I did not get paid by Fender or Seymour Duncan or anybody to do this. I just did this to describe this instrument to you and the way I have it set up. Maybe it gives you some good ideas that you can go forward with on your own instrument, especially if you have a Strat and you want to sort of tune it up a little bit and hot rod it somewhat. Another thing too is I'd like to hear from you guys in the comments section below your take on Stratocasters, you know, your idea of the way I got this guitar set up and the tone it gets and so on and so forth. So it'd be interesting to, you know, just kind of get your feedback too. Anyway, that's all I got for you today on this video. Thanks for joining me. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for your free lifetime membership. When you want more, you can always upgrade to either a basic or a premium lesson package and start studying the guitar courses that I've organized for the members of my website. As always, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on this video, so please comment. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again, and we'll catch up with you next week on my other channel for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. The Blues Guitar Styles ebook is a masterclass course covering a huge amount of information on the blues style. With 8, 12, and 16 bar blues progressions, classic blues styles, plus all the important chord patterns. There's over 50 pages of information, including sections on blues techniques like slide, alternate tuning, and bending. This ebook has everything the guitar player needs for a solid foundation in blues guitar, including 27 MP3 audio tracks for easy at-home study. Blues Guitar Styles is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.